How's it going, everyone? It is Panjno here, and in this video, I'm going to be bringing you a very quick Windows optimization which can help you improve your system's performance, improve your system's stability, and potentially avoid issues with things like updates, bugs, and glitches in the future. This optimization is quite basic, but it's incredibly quick, simple, and easy to apply on your system, and you can turn it both on and off within just seconds. If this is something that you are familiar with and you might have turned this off in the past, do use this video as a reminder to double check the setting, because on big Windows updates it might have re-enabled itself. Get Windows activated for a great price with WhoKeys. Use the links below for Windows 11, Windows 10 or Office. Apply code PAN20 at checkout for an additional 25% off. Secure payment options including PayPal are available. Once complete, just paste the key to activate Windows and remove the watermark. Windows 10 keys can also upgrade to Windows 11. Use the links in the description below, and thank you to WhoKeys for sponsoring. In this video, we're going to be covering Windows Fast Startup. This is a default setting for Windows 11 and Windows 10 on laptops and desktops. If you haven't manually disabled this yourself, it's more than likely running on your system, and it might sound like something you want to have enabled. In very basic terms, to explain this as quickly as possible, when you shut down your PC with this setting enabled, the current state of Windows is saved to your disk, hard drive, or SSD. When you press the power button to boot the system back up, that current state of Windows is then loaded from the disk back into the system RAM in hopes of giving you a faster startup time and having access to your applications and programs faster. The downside to using this is it means that in many cases, if you're shutting down your PC, it's not actually properly shutting down. This could lead to slight issues when applying Windows updates, or if you have bugs or glitches within the operating system itself, which a quick restart or a shutdown would fix, you won't be getting those fixes because Windows itself isn't fully shutting down. And on top of this, if you select the restart option instead of shutdown, you will actually have your PC fully cycle on and off and reset the state of the operating system, making the restart button a better alternative to shutdown. In this video, I'm going to be showing you how you can turn this both off and back on if you wish to re-enable it for any reason. I'd recommend switching it off, or at least switching it off for now, testing it on your system, and if there's no reason to re-enable it, just keep it turned off. Before we adjust the setting, we could see how long the system uptime actually is. On your desktop, go down to your taskbar, right-click, and select Task Manager. On Windows 11, go to the left-hand side to the Performance tab. For Windows 10 users, this will be found at the top. Click on CPU. If the CPU uptime is drastically longer than when you last shut down your system, this is a clear indication that your system is not completely shutting itself down. If the CPU uptime is in line with when you last shut down the PC, that's completely fine. You can also try out this setting and see if you do get benefits from using it, as it's so quick and easy just to turn back on. There's no real downsides to at least trying it off. To adjust the setting, go down to your Windows button, search for Power Space Plan. You can then select from either the Edit Power Plan or Choose Power Plan Options. Once you're inside of a Power Options page, go to the top navigation bar, select where it says Power Options. Inside of this page, go to the top left-hand side to choose what the power buttons do. If, like my system, you are unable to adjust the settings at the bottom if they are grayed out, all you need to do is select Change Settings that are currently unavailable. We can then adjust the option we're going to change, which is Turn On Fast Startup. This should be enabled by default on practically all Windows systems. If it's already off, it means that Fast Startup is already disabled and you're more than likely getting the benefits of this already. But if it's enabled, like on my system, which it is by default, all you need to do is uncheck this box, go to the bottom to save changes. Once that's complete, exit out, click on your Windows button, right-click on the power button, this time select Shut Down. Once the PC has completely shut itself down, it's no longer making any noise and the fans have stopped spinning, what you can then do is just boot it back up as you typically would. Once you're back at your desktop, go to your task bar, right-click, open Task Manager. Once again, go to the Performance tab, select CPU. Your CPU's uptime should now have successfully reset with your system shut down. This should now successfully be fully shutting down your entire system when you initiate a Windows shutdown. And you should be getting some of those benefits that we discussed at the beginning of this video. But if you decide that this isn't for you and you wish to revert this back, reselect the option to turn on fast startup, go to the bottom, select save changes. That will then bring you back to the default Windows behavior. But my personal preference on this machine is to actually keep it off, so I will be keeping this disabled. If you would rather not adjust the default setting, but have access to be able to properly shut down your PC every now and then, instead, when you shut down your PC, all you need to do is just simply hold the Shift key. Whilst holding the Shift key, press the Windows button, right-click on the power button, and select Shutdown whilst you continue to hold the Shift key. That will give you a successful full shutdown, but to make this simple, easy, and automated so your PC successfully fully shuts itself down every single time, which I recommend you do, just turn off that setting, press save. Next time you shut down the PC, you're good to go. And there you guys have it. Let me know your thoughts on this. Have you done this on your system in the past, or has Windows reset the setting back without you noticing? Check out the video on screen, and I'll see you in the next one.